Hello guys, so today we are going to talk about the perfect leg workout for home. Why I'm calling it is as perfect because in this workout we are selecting 6 exercises for the legs, but those exercises will cover everything in the leg, means from the glutes to hamstring to quadriceps, even the parts of quadriceps, like it is going to cover the VMO and the calf muscles. Also, the exercises will be in the centric and eccentric mode both. Why I am saying this? Because when we do exercises in the eccentric mode, then it's injury preventive. So it's very important to incorporate a lot of exercises which focuses on the eccentric way of doing the exercises, because the eccentric is the one of the most important way to prevent the further injuries like the hamstring strain or the adductor strain or these kind of things, right? Second thing, it is going to cover balance training as well. So we are going to train you for the balance training. It is very important. Why? Because it is a neuromuscular coordination. When we do train in the balance training mode, then we train our body, we train our joints, basically like the hip, knee, ankle and core, to work together, to work as a unit, because when we do balance training they all should work as a unit. So this prevents the injury, this will makes your muscles a bit more stronger and athletic. So all of these things we are going to do it today. So I have made a schedule for you guys, you know, which is simple 6 exercises. So as you can see, so we are going to do, first is lunges is my favorite exercise because it involves all the muscle groups in the leg at the same time. So backward and forward lunges, then we will be doing the jump squats, then single hip thrust, then Bulgarian jump squats, then goblet adductor lunges and the curtsy lunge. So this is the schedule, as you can see, is very simple. It is going to be tough, and enjoy guys. So when we start with the first thing is the backward and forward lunge. So for the backward and forward lunge, you assume the position. As you know, most of them, maybe you are a beginner. So for backward and forward lunge, I will go forward to the forward lunge, go backward to the backward lunge. Forward lunge, backward lunge. The important part in this, that my hip is coming straight down and my knees is not going forward than my toes. So few of the important point you need to remember: come straight down and your knee should not go forward than your toes. So we will do 10 sets of each leg. Now the second is jump squats. So jump squats are simple. You keep your legs shoulder width apart. You make a squat position, jump as high as you can, go down, make a squat position, jump as high as you can. In this also is very important that when I am doing the squats, my knees should not go beyond my toes, guys. You need to do the squats, take your hip backward, go down, jump, go down, jump, go down, jump. So we are going to do 15 repetition of this, right? Then is single hip thrust. So this is a very good exercise, mainly for the glutes. So for the single hip thrust, you can take a support of a sofa or if a bed or anything. You assume this position, make one leg straight, right? The one leg is straight, go up, hold, go down, hold, go up, hold, go down, hold, go up, go down. Very important, guys, when you go up, squeeze your glutes. It is for the glutes, so when you are going up, squeeze your glutes. The pressure should come from the hamstring and from the glutes. So we are going to do 15 repetitions of each leg, very tough. The fourth one is Bulgarian jump squats. So we are going to modify this bit. So I am going to do the Bulgarian jump squats in an eccentric mode. When I say eccentric mode, means I will keep one of my leg elevated. So I will go down very slowly. It's a kind of balance training as well, because I am balancing my whole body in one leg. So you go down very slowly, like in 4 to 5 seconds, and then jump. Go down very slowly, jump. Go down very slowly, jump. It's very important that you go down very slowly. When you go very slowly, your quadriceps work in eccentric mode. And jump. Depending upon your stamina, you can do 10 sets of each leg. Very important. This is one of the very beautiful exercises known as goblet adductor lunge. In this, I need to remove my shoes because we need a slippery surface. So the socks is very good. So wear a sock so that it becomes slippery. Assume a position in which your legs are about shoulder width distance. So in the first 10 sets, I am going to take my right leg away by gliding, and I will do the side lunge posture like this. Go, go, go. Go down, down, down. And you're coming back, just glide back. Don't lift your leg and come back. Go gliding, go gliding, go gliding, go down and glide back. The surface should be slippery for this. These are very good exercises for the hip adductors and abductors. Go glide back. So you need to do 10 repetitions of each of the leg. The last one is known as curtsy lunge. So it's also a kind of balance training, and it involves almost all of the muscles of the leg. So for the curtsy leg, for the curtsy lunges, I will keep my legs, my foot shoulder width apart, and from my right leg I will go backward and do the lunges. But I'm also crossing it, guys. I'm crossing it. It is not the backward lunges. So basically I am going backward and crossing it, crossing my leg, doing the lunge, coming back. Going backward, crossing my leg, doing the lunge, coming back. I will show you from the sideways also. So backward, crossing the leg, doing the lunge, right? From this direction, as you can see, I need to cross, do the lunge and come back. I need to cross, do the lunge and come back. Same way, I need to cross, do the lunge, come back. So guys, these are the 6 exercises. Do either 10 sets each or 15 sets each, depending upon your stamina. This is one set. We need to do at least 4 to 5 sets of these exercises, and it's going to be killer leg workout, and exhaust yourself. Why I'm saying exhaust yourself is very important. As we see, the muscles, our muscles are made up of different motor units. There are so many motor units in a single muscle group. If we talk about quadriceps or hamstring, there are so many muscle units. So when we start exercises, not all the motor units, the muscles, not all the motor units are recruited, right? But when we do 10 sets, 11 sets, 12 sets, maybe 15, most of them will be experiencing fatigue. At that point, there are few motor units which is going to recruit, because every other muscle unit which was recruited before is exhausted now. So that is the point. That is the point where you need to exert more. You need to do at least 3 or 4 repetition more when you get super tired. So guys, very important, no pain, no gain. You need to fatigue yourself. When you fatigue yourself, then only your all of the motor units is going to function, and you will develop a bigger and more powerful muscle later on. Hope you enjoy this, guys. Stay tuned Follow my Instagram, YouTube for the more updates, and I will be posting a lot of videos about the home workout. And the important thing is that it is going to be combination of all the muscle group. I'm not going to focus on one muscle group. It will be balance training, it will be injury prevention, it will be everything. So basically the most important exercise is to develop the leg, to reduce the injuries, to be pain-free, whether it's a hip pain or knee pain, it will go. Thank you guys, enjoy.